Howdy everybody, BygPhattyPlus, and welcome back to the Big Man Plays Dreamfall Chapters. When we last left off, we were trying to get into Obnoxious' abode, but we had to get rid of Honor Hillaris to do it. Too bad I didn't actually get to strike him. But oh well, anyway, we're going into the house.
Locked, but I have the key.
Yes, let's use this key.
This place looks a lot bigger on the inside. It is a lot bigger on the inside. Okay, this is freaky. I feel dizzy. There must be magic here because this makes no sense. Things can't be bigger on the inside than on the outside. Then again, why should I be surprised? I've seen weirder things. Weird is my new normal. Right, so, clues.
Let's look around here. What the hell's this?
Obnoxious must have been a big believer in crystals. Or maybe this is how people light their houses. Maybe this is totally normal for Arcadia.
Okay, that's,
Those are some portentous-looking books. I wish I could read them.
What's this?
This place has the slightly tacky ambience of a New Age shop.
Oh, what the hell is this? That's a book? Why is it round?
Oh, that's interesting.
Get out of my...
Whoa, Nelly!
Holy crap!
Easy, easy. There's nothing to worry about. Zoe Castillo. You're literally the last person
I expected
to find in here.
Brian?
I remember him from my last visit to Mercuria. Brian, right?
Right. Brian. Brian Westhouse.
Wait a minute.
We spent a few days in cramped quarters on a small airship. I'd be surprised if you didn't remember me.
It's been a confusing year. For a while, I remember nothing. Even when I tried my best to remember, I couldn't. Well, not until now.
I know that feeling all too well, Miss Castillo. So you're back in Mercuria, and in this place of all places. How in the name of the balance did you get inside? People have been trying for years, but this house has strong wards. Venar magic, the oldest there is. And now I understand why. It's a treasure trove. Like that book you were looking at. That's the Annals of Dreaming. Only 5 were ever made. It must be worth... Well, it's valuable. Extremely valuable.
Why be secretive about it? I'm sure I can trust him.
I don't know.
I'm not sure I want to tell this man absolutely everything yet.
I don't know. He seemed a little off.
I know my way around wards.
So I see. Your talents run deeper than I remember, Miss Castillo. I'm impressed. Pardon my curiosity, but what are you looking for here? Obnoxious himself vanished a decade ago.
I should trust Brian. There's no point hiding anything from him. It's not that I don't trust him, but...
He seems a little off!
I was just curious about what was in here.
You know what they say about curiosity, Miss Castillo?
It killed the cat?
What? No. curiosity is the doorway to knowledge and wisdom. Looks like I picked the perfect day for a stroll in the green. I was wondering why that odorous Hillaris fellow wasn't still trying to chop this tree down. Now I know. Let's see if we find anything interesting, shall we?
Sure. Sure, what map?
It's a map of the Northlands, and the border mountains are right at the top, but no purple mountains. Lots of other mountains, though. Without a reference to the purple mountains, that map won't help me.
Interesting.
Mr. Westhouse. Brian. He seems very enthusiastic and friendly. Probably. I have a hard time reading him, to be honest.
I'm a little concerned. Ooh, what? Nope. What's this? What is this?
Looks like a handwritten note. It's another one of Abnaxis's notes. Westhouse might be able to decipher that note.
Oh, of course. You can't read it on your own? Oh, note there. Another frickin' note. Really?
This is fascinating.
Notes. Notes everywhere. Looks like a handwritten note.
Okay, let's, I never got to go upstairs when I was here with, April. I want to look up... Oh, okay, so he did have a bed.
Abnaxis must have made the bed before leaving for good.
All those years,
that's kind of sad
and
eerie.
Under my nose.
Someone's been sleeping in my bed, said Papa Bear, before mauling Goldilocks and devouring her whole. Don't ever mess with fairy tale creatures.
What? That's not how the story went at all!
What does this mean?
It's another one of Abnaxis's notes.
Uh-huh.
Abnaxis was a very well-read man. Thing.
Wasn't
Abnaxis must have been a big believer
right.
in crystals. Or maybe this is how people light their houses. Maybe this is totally normal for Arcadia.
I don't know. Hey,
I was wrong about that part. But at least... Have you found anything of interest? Keep looking. This place is a treasure trove.
Here's another note.
On the matter of the kin and the approaching War of the Balance. By Jove, this is the information we've been looking for. I can't believe it was right here all this time. Your help has been invaluable, Zoe. I'm in your debt.
Oh, achievement. Man of notes. I also have,
What do you think this means?
I'm not sure there's much to learn from that one.
What about this
looks interesting.
The first dreamer references in the Annals of Dreaming, that's this book right here. And the chapter about the first dream, it's certainly a starting point. Let's see what it says.
Can you read that book?
I've lived in Arcadia for decades, and there hasn't been much to do aside from studying ancient texts, so yes, I can read this book.
Let's see,
the chapter in question speaks of the Ular. They are said to be wardens of the Dreaming One, whatever that means. It's a rough translation. The English language isn't quite up to the task. The Ular and the Yeti, one people that split into two. That sounds familiar. It says here the Yeti left the Purple Mountains to go south to burrow into the ground. Something about a well of dreams. I mean, I don't know how much of this is true and how much is fantasy or prophecy. It's a difficult book to decipher. There's also something about two dreamers becoming one. It's vague. This is almost certainly a prophecy of some sort. The Ular live on Cloud Peak. It's in the mountains of Yedra. Where's that on the map? Ah, there it is. Straight north across the plains, right in the middle of the border mountains.
I like that level.
This is an old book, so... I don't know if they still live there. I've never heard of the Ular. They might all be dead.
Oh, that's not good. But what about that fallen note there? What's this?
That note fell out of the annals when Westhouse turned the pages. That note fell out of the annals when Westhouse turned the pages. This note fell out from the pages of the annals. What's a soulless stone?
I'm not
soul
sure.
Soul stone.
The Soul Stone was taken from Luke's by the warlock Clax.
Oh,
must
God.
Be retrieved, or the past, present, and future will cease to be.
That sounds ominous.
Very ominous.
It does indeed. I don't know about any Soul Stone, but I'm guessing this Clax fellow does. I wonder if Abnaxis means old Roper Clax. April told me his story. He was a two-bit wizard who resided in a floating castle up north near the border mountains. April said she taught him a lesson. She didn't get into any details, but he lost his castle. Last I heard, he's doing children's theater here in town. Reformed, apparently, if that's a thing a wizard is capable of. Sounds like this soul stone is important.
Oh.
I'm sure Abnaxis won't mind me borrowing this. I'll return it to him in person, if I make it to Cloud Peak.
Huh.
Let's see. There. Cloud Peak, just like the book said. This is it! This shows the way to the Purple Mountains.
The War of the Balance.
Let's see.
Finally,
there.
Something
Cloud Peak, just like the book said. This is it! This shows the way to the Purple Mountains.
I got an achievement that said, MAPS! Like, okay.
Abnaxis left so much behind. There's a wealth of information here.
Okay. Yeah. Okay, yeah, I'm just going to let you go there. You have fun with
that,
bud.
I should get going. Should we...
Would you mind terribly if I stayed here to read these books?
Well, this is... It's private property, isn't it?
Abnaxis isn't coming back, and I've been itching for a chance to peruse his library for years now.
Don't you ask me.
I won't remove anything or make a mess.
Just let... Oh, God! So many people refuse! Oh, God!
The best of intentions, but I made a promise to Blind Bob. I'd feel awful if anything happened to Abnaxis's abode. It doesn't look like Brian's gonna do any damage to the place. He's respectful and curious. It couldn't hurt to let him stay.
No! You gotta leave! Get out the house!
I'm sorry. I don't think I can let you stay in here.
I'm not sure I need your permission.
Excuse me?
Only joking. I understand. I'll take my leave now, Miss Castillo. I certainly hope we'll see each other again soon.
That was... Like the way he frickin' said. Can I? What's this book? Let me look at this book right quick. Oh, I can't look at that book. Can I lock that door? I would like to lock that door. Jump cut!
Didn't you say something about a wizard and a puppet show?
Nope.
No, you did. You said something about a show in the square.
I did not.
Crow.
Oh, right! Roper Clax's Fingerlings!
Did he? I don't remember.
Man, that show's great. A modern classic.
Clax. He's the wizard April Ryan fought.
That's right. He was behaving badly, so she fought him and trapped him inside some sort of calculating machine. Pretty clever stuff.
Where can I find this puppet show?
I'll show you.
Can I?
Closed and locked. At least until Abnaxis comes back.
Yeah, I don't find it. He's acting too weird. Plus that picture that little Saga made of him hiding stuff inside make me really not trust Brian. I just don't trust him. I'm glad they got the same voice actor back, though. To be honest, if I hadn't said that. Wrong without magicals around. I barely see any.
This is gonna be so good.
Hey, is there any show? Oh, we got some characters. Shannon, Livid, Parla, Meryl, Jenna, David, Adam, Edith, Brian, really? April and Clax. Really? You made your... Clax!
Roper Clax, I presume. He looks wizardly, as in how I expected wizards to look when I was 10.
If you seek an autograph, you must purchase my book first. It's on sale today.
It's only same voice actor.
Sorry, I need to talk to you.
Talk? Well, I only have a few minutes before my show begins, but I'm sure I can spare a couple of them for a pretty young thing like you.
This has to be the right man. You are Roper Clax, right? The wizard?
Who told you that?
Well, that sign, for one.
No, the wizard part. Who told you? I mean, I'm merely a humble finger puppeteer trying to make an honest living in a cold and heartless world.
But you were a wizard once.
Fully rehabilitated, I don't go anywhere near sorcery, not anymore. You should really read my highly acclaimed and best-selling memoir, A Farewell to My Wizarding Ways.
There's only one copy.
It's a thrilling story of redemption and romance, of dashing heroes and wicked villainesses, of flying castles and curious calculating devices. Every word of it as true as the night is dark and the day is bright, of course.
It's an odd name for a children's puppet show. Didn't he and April have some sort of confrontation?
Yes, he did.
Do you remember April Ryan?
April Wright? Oh, yes, of course, absolutely, certainly, naturally, the bitch...
Watch your tongue, boy!
...young woman who came to my castle and stole it, and helped me put my sorceress past behind me. How could I possibly forget?
He's obviously got some issues with April. I'd be curious to learn more. So, about April.
Why does everyone want to talk about April Ryan? She was just a weak little human who stumbled onto things she didn't...
BOY!
No, I must apologize. You see, April and I had some disagreements in the past. I'm past that now. I'm a different person. As for April Ryan, I hear she suffered an ignoble death at the hands of our Azadi benefactors. What a shame. What a terrible, terrible shame.
It's an odd name for a children's puppet show. The Fingerlings.
Ah, my beloved finger puppets, beloved by all children and critics alike. Gilbert Grutton of the Daily Mercurian called my show simply astonishing and wrote that it was quite impossible to look away. I couldn't believe my eyes and like a slow-motion cart wreck. You see, the Fingerlings represent a revolution in finger puppeteering, or as I call it, fingering. Trademark and patent pending. The women in particular are quite ecstatic about it. Stay for the show. I guarantee a good time.
Roper.
We'll get right to it, seeing as his show is about to begin.
Oh.
Do you recall owning a soul stone?
A soul stone? I don't know what you're talking about.
Don't you lie to me!
I was just wondering, since there are so many impressive tales about your powers where I come from.
And where would that be?
That was a long time ago. In another life. I've moved on. I'm a different person now, in every way.
I was just wondering what happened to the stone.
She took it, that bitch.
Balance? Pardon me? I don't know where that came from.
Who?
The Yaga. the Wicked Witch of the North, mm-hmm. as these simpletons call her. As if they have any idea who and what she truly is. She lurks in Riverwood in the dark places. She feeds on that stone like a...
Like I said, that's in the past, and I've left it all behind long ago. Now I make an honest living bringing joy to children through my most excellent and revolutionary finger puppet theater. And on that note, I must beg your pardon, young miss. The show is about to begin.
Can we please talk again afterwards? I have some more questions.
Sure. Absolutely. After the show. After the show. Yes. Toodaloo.
Okay. Let's watch the...
Yes, here we go.
Let's watch the show. Oh, this will be
going to be so good.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, humans and... Well, humans... And you, Azadi soldier standing over there, you're welcome to watch. Just don't rattle your sabers or rustle your suits. Welcome to this morning's performance of The Fingerlings. I am your host and puppeteer, Roper Clax, esteemed thespian and raconteur, author and entrepreneur. My book is available for purchase with a free personalized dedication. Speak to me after the show.
A
donation is both appreciated and expected. Drop your coins into the box after the show. Remember that every iron piece goes towards a good purpose.
Woohoo! Go, Fingerlings!
My beloved Fingerlings! Handcrafted reproductions of renowned actors from across Arcadia, immortalized in finger puppet form by skilled artisans. Using only the finest fabrics and natural materials, these lovely creatures are as dear to me as children and as talented and protean as the finest human players. You're all welcome to approach the stage after the show, of course, to admire my finely crafted miniatures up close and intimately. No food, no touching, no children. And now, beloved audience, prepare yourselves for a journey into mystery, for a true story of wizardry and magic. I present to you the tale of the good-hearted wizard and the villainous witch. Once upon a time, in the distant north, there lived a kindly old wizard in a wonderful flying castle.
Reformed my butt.
This very friendly wizard liked to tease and toy with the people of the land, and sometimes he would do silly things like turn them into stone or furry animals and bottle up the wind.
You did more than that, you jerk.
Naturally, he meant no harm, and the people of the land love the wizard like they would a grandfather, a very young and very, very handsome grandfather.
No.
But one day, an evil sorceress a distant land came to visit the kindly wizard. This ugly, selfish witch didn't understand that the wizard was only trying to make people happy. She used her dark sorcery to steal all of his possessions and trap him inside a tiny little box where the gentle wizard was barely able to breathe. The poor old man was trapped for many moons inside this box before a benevolent wandering god arrived to free him from his prison. The wizard pledged eternal allegiance to the wandering god in return for vengeance against the cruel witch who trapped him. Together they...
There he is, Commander. The dangerous loon who's corrupting our youth with his occult fingerings.
What? Oh. What's this? What are you doing? What's going on? You can't... Hey, hands off!
You're teaching children of magic, old man. You ought to know better.
Release me, you dishonorable brute!
By the authority vested in me by the Greater Azadi Empire and the Emissary.
Shut up!
In accordance with provisional imperial law prohibiting any and all teachings of occult magic, I'm taking you into custody.
You can't do this! You don't know who I am!
Tell it to the magistrate, wizard.
My fingerlings! My precious handcrafted fingerlings! No!
I can't believe that they arrested him. What a travesty.
Hey, kid.
I don't think he's alone in there. He has company. There's something wrong with him. When I looked at his face, I saw shadows.
What?
Stupid wizard, he's still trapped. But this time he's trapped inside himself. I don't think he's alone in there.
Okay.
He has company.
I didn't see that coming.
I guess the Azadi aren't fans of creepy puppet shows either.
I think it had more to do with him being a wizard. Okay, shit. So what now? He was my only lead to the Soul Stone. All I have to go on is something about a Yaga and Riverwood.
Riverwood? I know Riverwood. I've been to Riverwood. If it's Riverwood you need, I know how to get to Riverwood.
Really? And the Yaga? The Wicker Witch?
I don't know anything about Yagas, but I do know something about witches in Riverwood. On my last trip there, we had a close encounter with one of them.
Wait.
That witch is toast, of course, but I can probably find my way back to Riverwood. It's north. We go north. Wait, which way is up? Yeah, north!
Okay. Okay. That's something, right? Much better than nothing. We just need a way to get north that doesn't involve me walking all the way.
Or me flying. I'm not flying all that way. I tire easily.
I bet.
Wait. I feel a cunning plan coming on. Follow me, Zoe.
Uh-oh.
It's either a cunning plan, or I need the toilet. But I'm pretty sure it's a cunning plan.
You don't use the toilet. You're a bird. You poop in the air on people. You don't need a cunning plan. Oh, we're riding Elkhorn.
I still can't believe you pulled off the voice and the whole fake hand thing.
The hat looked great on you.
Totally. Not so sure about the beard, though. My face is itchy.
Oh, I would love
Speaking
to see that.
Speaking of faces, I can never show mine in Mercuria again. Not after that last bit we did.
If everything goes well, you won't have to.
At least we have a ride. Can I trust this thing?
They're docile cows, the Elguan. Just leave it to me. Mush, Daisy. Mush!
Don't upset her.
I think you're upsetting her.
I'll leave the cowgirling to you. I'll fly ahead and scout the terrain instead. Don't lose sight of me!
Okay, we got a ride. Okie dokie. Oh, so we're back here now. Okay.
How much longer will this journey take? Must be nearly a week now.
It's been less than 2 days, and I'm beginning to regret bringing you along.
You're stuck in the cargo hold of a cloud ship with your worst enemy. How could you possibly have any regrets?
And people say you have no sense of humor. We're on a mission. This is neither the time nor place to make peace with Liko. We already fight side by side. That's our bond. Besides, I'm tired. If there was ever a time to make peace with Liko, this is likely it. Maybe there's still a chance to create a bond between us.
Oh, sure, why not?
I'm sorry about your father. I know that may not amount to much now, but I was a different person then. I was blind to the possibility that there could be more than one truth. There's been so much death on the road to this place. I murdered an innocent man during my escape from Friar's Keep. He begged me to, but I still don't know if I did the right thing. When I visited his widow, she only had hate for me. She couldn't understand my reasons for doing what I did.
I guess we should let him die.
I ran Balsebakim through and watched him bleed to death so that I could make my escape through a blood magic portal. I still wonder if his sacrifice was worth it. Have I repaid that debt? Shepard believes so. But many thought him a better man than I, so why did he have to die? I've tortured men for information. What did I gain from these actions? What did it change? What would have been different had I acted differently? All of these choices, Liko, they add up. My soul is heavy. The others believe me unaffected because I carry on as if nothing happened. But their faces and voices are there when I close my eyes. Those deaths never leave me. No words can undo these deeds. There are no excuses for the wrongs I've committed. But I am trying to heal the wounds I've inflicted. It's a long journey, Liko. And
I know. When you arrived from Friar's Keep, I wanted you dead.
Really? I couldn't tell.
People say you have no sense of humor.
They do?
We've been through much since
then. They do? Wait a minute.
I believe I know you. A little. You've taken up arms against your own people, risking shame, death, and your immortal soul. Because you believe they're misguided. It cannot be easy being hated and feared by both sides. I may still despise you because you murdered my father. I may still dislike you because you're an arrogant and intolerant shit. But I respect you, Kian. And I trust you.
Let's see, everybody. Oh, God, get serious. We're gonna make it like
intolerant shit.
Too harsh?
You may have a point.
Anyway, I'm exhausted. All this male camaraderie takes its toll. Keep to your side of the hold, or I may accidentally stab you in my sleep.
Keep your side of the hold. I may accidentally stab you in my sleep. We're all over. Stab. Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't mean that. Chapter 10. Umbre. Oh, wait. That looks different! That looks different! Also, where in the Sam Hill are we? Isn't it uncomfortable to sit like that?
Oh!
Hey! Hey! Daisy! God dang it.
Fuck. Oh, I mean, that hurt.
Never trust an Elgwan, cowardly cows.
Oh, something must have spooked it. What do we do now?
This place looks familiar. I think we're close. In fact, what? I think we're...
Leave! Go, or I'll call the others.
Who the hell?
Whoa, hey there, I'm friendly and unarmed.
You're human. You can't be Bird? Crowbird?
Wait a minute.
Hello. Hey, you're that fretful furry thing we met the first time we came.
Oh my god!
Ben Franklin.
No.
Ben Bandu. This isn't the same human who accompanied you last time.
This is my new human. She's mostly harmless. Say hello, Zoe. Don't be rude.
Hi. Let me pause, because, so, apparently, not all the Banda are dead. Ben's right over there, and, yeah. So, okay, what's... He probably spooked our Elkwan, which is now going to go into the forest and get eaten by something. So, Kian and Liku are forming a somewhat tense friendship. And we're back in the forest and there's a Banda. What's going on? And are we going to be facing the Baba Yaga? Or are we facing the Baba Yaga? Is it going to be the same one that April killed? Find out next time on the Big Man Plays Dreamfall Chapter. It's a nice Big Fatty Plus. Sayonara. And, Ben, just so you know, you'd have been a lot more threatening if you weren't pointing at just a stick. If you had, like, me, at least those, like a stone sword or something, it might be at least slightly threatening. But, a stick is about as, you know, threatening as a sharp stick in the eye. That's not even a sharp stick.